Hello viewers all over the world. We bless the name of the Lord for being the viewers of our programs on Recovery TV channels. This is another moment of recovery. Today we have some testimonies for you, and we believe after this program your life will not remain the same. Amen.
So the Almighty God is a God that formed you, put ears, put fingers on your hands that he has fixed on your body.
What else do I want? I said that I want God's financial blessing upon my husband. And the man of God prayed with
that,
me.
That very day, the man of God said, you don't get understanding that you are having a problem. Hey, I said, man of God, you have seen me. Oh God, let me go.
Now, cast everywhere. As the problem went away, and I saw blessing flow. As the peace coming, I saw the blessing flow everywhere.
Was so terrible. I wanted to open the door, but the sum was so much. I closed the door. I was in.
You know, say, the Lord is my shield, like the one that is on your vest. Now, he has so many things. My God is my protector.
If you sleep with a man that is not your husband, do you know it's a sin? I started crying. Praise the Lord.
Instance, sorry, you never explained this issue to the apostle.
Bless you. Welcome once again to your exciting moment of recovery. This is Moment of Recovery with me.
This woman you are seeing on your screen joined this ministry not quite long, and she have started experiencing turnaround in her family. Few weeks back, God saved her from untimely death when a deck in her bedroom fell directly on her bed. Immediately, she left to sitting room.
My name is Sister Blessing Okoro. I was the same woman that was here last week to testify about the falling of the decking.
Oh, the fallen decking.
After that, she came for counseling, and the man of God, Apostle Edmund, pray for her and her family.
Last week Wednesday, I was here for counseling. In fact, that was my very first day of coming for counseling. Luckily enough for me, I was attended to. I saw the man of God. He prayed with me and asked me what I desire from God. And I told him, although I left some side, he still insisted by asking me, what else do I want? I said that I want God's financial blessing upon my husband. And the man of God prayed with me. In fact, he prayed for me and gave me a sticker.
Apostle Edmund prayed for her and her family. That same week, the husband begins to experience turnaround in his place of work.
On Friday, that Thursday, I told him that the man of God prayed for me, and I mentioned your own case to him, and he prayed for you also. Could you believe they who've long been desiring for children of our own, and then we have also long desired for a car of our own. So the car that they placed for bid in his place of work for a very long time that they refused to say anything about. On Friday, I was at my place of work, and he called me and told me that he has been favored, that the car has been given to him.
Wonderful clap offering unto the Lord.
Log into our channel www.recoverytouch.tv.
This book will help you to know how to marry as a minister, when to marry, how to conduct your family, I mean, including your children, if there are any. You know how to conduct them. And you should know also the relationship between the church and the family. You also know how to keep the family of God, even the church. I mean, as a minister, what must you do to be qualified in the calling and the service of God? No, think about that. You see, this book has, you know, some information for you, as I said, as a plus to all you have known, but you have not any experience about ministerial supervisory mandate. Well, Praise God. This will help you. And according to what I read behind here, it said the book, it said this book is a supervisor. Is a supervisor. It's a handbook, friendly book. Friendly handbook. You always look to it and make references on how to operate as a minister of God. And God richly bless you.
They have a lockdown cast everywhere. As the problem went away, I saw blessing flow. As the peace coming, I saw the blessing lockdown cast everywhere. As the problem went away, I saw blessing flow. As the peace coming, I saw the blessing flow.
This woman has been experiencing ugly moments in her marriage for the past 8 years. Until she brought her case to God through one of her servants, tagged anointed service.
Alice Kofi.
Alice.
Kofi.
Kofi.
Yes.
Ovie or Biofie.
Kofi. Kofi.
Kofi.
Yes.
Are you from Ghana?
Yes.
All right. Go ahead.
My testimony is that the past 8 years, there's no peace in my marriage.
For the past eight years. For the past 8 years.
Yes.
There was no peace
in my marriage.
In your marriage, yep.
Yes. Every day, my husband would drink and come home with a cockroach. He would push at me. When would they sleep? She would use knife to cut me, cut all part of my body. She would drink. Both the children, the way he's beating me, that's the way that she would beat the children. Even the new baby, if I born a new baby, she would conk the baby head. He said, you say he must cry. Every day, we would run, come off our house. We would run, go sleep our neighbor house. We would run, go to some places to sleep. No peace. We can't sleep because of the fear. My children are fearing. Others came back home, we see say no drink. Everybody will sleep. But when he drink, all of us will run, come on the whole house. We'll leave the building for him. And we'll find me anyway, confirm that I sleep here. She'll go there and find those people that should not accept us. They want to kill us, me and my children. I was continue pray. Family fell up. My family fell up. The whole family then fell up. Everybody, even the copper, both the landlord. Both police saw that we drag ourselves to the station. Police then fed up for a marriage. Fed up for the marriage. I said, okay, I'll continue praying. The family called me, said, I should divorce the man. I said, I can't go anywhere with this, my small children. Who will feed me? They said, we're ready to feed me. I said, only one day feeding. I can't go anywhere. I will pray for this man to change. If you are fed up, police fed up, the family of him fed up, the father of my father fed up, me, I'll stand, I'll pray. This man will change. I was continuing praying, come to anointing service with his name, write his name everywhere. We'll pray.
Hold on. You made a statement now. You say you come to anointing service.
Yes, I was praying
you
for him.
You come to anointing service, and what are some of those things you tell God about the man? What are some of those things?
In my center, they know me, because every day we see my eyes blood, we see my hand cut, we see my head. They don't teach my head. Your man don't teach my head more than 5 places. My center, they know me every day. This year, 31st night, I was 31st night, I put in case for the altar that the Lord will change my husband. Whether he like it or not, he will change. I was in the fellowship when he came. He don't drink. Then give him a chair. He said, no. Then give him this chair. People that come, they all start, they comfort him to sin. I said, no. He was looking at, he was just defying the whole fellowship. I was just the fear. I said, hey, God, what can I do? This man don't come again. As he just saw me, and he just come, he asked me 2 questions. He said, I should pick 2 words. He said, the grace. And to stand up and throw into the house, which I will take. He used language.
I didn't get that.
He said, for me to digress and to stand up and throw into the house, which I will take. I said, let me stand up. I don't want to take the grace. So I stand up. He said, I want to enter 2014. I said, yes, now this is 31st night. I must enter 2014. He just laughed. He said, I lie. Let's go home. I follow you. That's it. After 12, sharp. I leave my children. He said, I should leave the children. Let us go home. I follow him to home. I was at night to a compound like this. He said, should they flaunt?
And he has already drunk that day.
He don't drunk. I don't flaunt. He said, should they flaunt? He wants to enter to now for. I said, we don't already enter. This is the one now. He said, go flaunt. I said, they flaunt. I don't even know what he did knock me from my back here. As he knocked me, I fall down, faint. She run away. The day they pour me water. I get myself. I stand up. I said, where is, I just asked the woman, where is the point? I said, where is my husband? He said, your husband don't knock you something. No. We don't see ourselves. After a minute, after 2, he come back. He said, he never die.
I was thinking that the day more surely, and he don't wake. Why did you wake? I said, now go wake me up because I don't want to die. I know you go kill me. No, you go. I don't put your case for evil striver. Your today case, you will end. You say, you don't know anything. You don't know what I will do you. Many people come up for this company. You know what I will do you.
Until she brought her case to God through one of our service, tagged an OT service. During this service, she brought her husband's case to God through prayer. After the man of God and the church prayed, God transformed her marriage.
Do you? I said nothing will happen. I was continuing to pray with that pain in my head like this because I can't catch myself. I don't know what it did knock me. I was praying. Since that time, the Lord touched my husband. Everything changed. Those feelings moved. So I used to stand and watch my husband. I said, is that this man? Everything changed. The life changed. I said, we're begging food. They won't come for the whole area. They know that I'm Mrs. Begging. We used to beg food before we eat. I'll go here beg. If I beg up, if I cook in the food, you eat the food and leave us. You pack everything and eat. But now, everything changed. If you see my husband, then everything changed. All the yoke, even you don't want to smell the spirit of heart, everything changed for our life. Anything that our hearts will give, you come back home. It happened not now, cast everywhere.
Today, the family is experiencing peace and blessings.
As the problem went away, I saw blessing flow. As the peace coming, I saw the blessing flow everywhere. Everything changed. In my company now, people are supplying. Both the family of me, both my family, people are supplying. They say, what do you do for your husband? I say, it's anointing service. Oh. It's anointing service. If you want to know, go to our table. It's anointing service. My husband is changed. Daddy, my husband is changed. Everything is okay.
What are you experiencing in your marriage, career, and life that seems God can't do? All things are possible with God. Join us in any of our recovery services. You shall rejoice because anointing changes things.
Is that over tea? Is that bomb bitter? So that when I screwed my face, I said, what is the problem? It's all over. Why are you squeezing your face?
Now, when you squeeze your face, he said, darling, why?
What is the problem?
Anointing changes things as we pray. With anointing, condition must change. Anointing changes things. Anointing changes things. Oh, brethren, please let us pray. Yes, anointing changes things. Anointing changes things. Anointing changes.
That very day, that man of God said, you don't get understanding that you are having a problem. Hey,
this lady also experienced new beginning in her life during one of her Friday recovery hour. She has been suffering from a disease called epilepsy. People with epilepsy tend to have recurrent seizures. The seizures occur because of a sudden surge of electrical activity in the brain.
Last week, from Monday, if I'm just going out, I'll just fall down. I'm going out, I'll fall down. I said, what is this, oh God? People said, it's epilepsy. Oh, I said, epilepsy, no parents. What am I going to explain to? I explained to my auntie. My auntie said, what is this? That I should stop going out. I should be staying inside. I said, hey, this is problem. If I want to go and eat myself, I will just fall down. My auntie just covered me that nobody will see me. I say, hey.
When she goes out, she will fall down.
Yeah. So, on Friday, I came to miracle service. I said, since I cannot go out,
You came miracle service.
Yes. I said, sister,
on Friday.
This Friday. I said, sister, I cannot go out. How am I going to go to church?
They were very hot.
My sister is not, nobody is at home. I said, today Friday, I'm going to be here. I'll go. So now, I came to the service.
What amazed me was that when ministration was going on, man of God pointed to her and mentioned her case. Behold, during the prayer that day, she got her deliverance.
I was sitting at the center there. So the man of God came. He said, the topic of today will be shooting from heaven.
Excuse me to give you the title of this message as shooting from heaven.
Hey, I say God.
Yeah. Shooting from heaven.
Yes.
That was the message.
Yes, sir.
Shooting from heaven.
I said, today I'm going to receive my healing. Nothing. The devil will never have power over me. I sit there. I started praying. I said, God, bullet from heaven. God, answer my prayer. I started praying.
So your own prayer point was bullet from heaven?
Yes, sir. I said, okay. I started praying. I said, oh God, let me 4 years so that the man of God will even see me now. This problem is, this guy is having. That way, that man of God said, you don't get understanding that you are having a problem. Hey, I said, this man of God, you have seen me. Oh God, let me go. This man of God, from there, the man of God just as a removed face from me, started preaching. I said, God.
He said, but he pointed at you, he confirmed that you are having a problem. Okay.
Yeah. I said, God, I started praying, I said, praying. Yes, the man of God came to. Every one of us at the stand sitting there, he touched us. Touched everyone. He said, if you believe that God has blessed you, come out. He touched us, he prayed to us. I fell down. Oh my mind is that I fell down for the normal I believe this is healing. So after I fell down, I just stand up. In the next 3 minutes, I just go to my seat. I'm going home. I say, God, I should not fall, so I'm going no more.
Since then, she stopped falling. Date.
Since that Friday, have you fallen again?
To this moment I'm standing. Oh!
You can order for some of our materials, messages on VCD, DVD, audio, and books written by the man of God, Apostle Edmund. Strategic Church Worship, Families and the Church, Faith Empowerment, Origin of Human Being, The Saints of God, Source of the Prophet, Typology. Just dial any of this number on your screen and make your order. God richly bless you.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground sinking sand, all other ground is sinking sand.
Psalm 61 verse 5. For you, O God, have heard my vows. You have given me the heritage of those who fear your name.
My hope is built.
Over 30 years ago, this woman was tormented by the devil. Her children, twins, were affected with measles, which resulted to taking them from one hospital to the other.
God help me, all this one, not twist. So, now this church, I carry them, I lay for a while with me here. So, God help me from Mama Anna, where I live for Oja Market. And I go, now, some of you, where they old here. So, now that, I carry me come for this ministry. As they do that thing, they carry these children, they sick. Mezzo, if you see this one, he know they eat. Now they go put a format, they will do it like this. So as they go put a money format, they say make it stone of coral spoil. Now so we gotta go hospital. Save for hospital. They destroyed us. Say make we go.
Despite all medical attention, there was no hope for her until a friend introduced her to this ministry. After the prayer of the man of God, Apostle Edmund, God manifested his power instantly and they were healed.
As we know, person sick, they say carry them from house to come hospital. That sickness, they don't do too much. God will help. Today, they die alive. And I promise God, say, if I don't know God's big children marry, I will come here, come thank God. Now make me today, I say, I go come here. As God help this one, come here. Come Lagos. I say, I'm surely come.
After the healing, she made a vow that if God could spare the lives of these twins and they get married, she vowed to bless the name of the Lord. The twins are still alive. Today, she's here to say thank you, Jesus. Ecclesiastes 5:4. When you vow to God, do not delay paying it, for he has no pleasure in fools.
I didn't know that the Lord is telling me that put this thing there, I'm going to use it to protect you. He has been protecting me, but he used it as a form that he is going to use it to protect me. All of us witnessed what happened on the 13th of this month, the storm that came.
Our God is a protector. God protected this man and his household from heavy storm. The storm that protected the entire roof of the house is close to him. A hair sticker tied to God is my protector placed at the entrance door of his house. When the heavy storm came, God protected him. Hallelujah.
I tell you, this thing I'm about to tell you, my brother who is here, Brother Vincent Mbata, is a witness. Sister Lovina, who is in the choir, is a witness. And I've shown it to some brethren from my phone. As the storm was on, was so terrible, I wanted to open the door, but the storm was so much, I closed the door I was in. What I heard was a very heavy noise after the whole thing. I you know, when the rain was falling, the rain fell very brief. What I saw was my room that was not leaking before, a part of it was leaking. I see something has happened. When I heard the noise, I was thinking that the whole roof has flown off. But after the storm, I came out, I looked, and the zinc was still there. But I saw a lot of new plank were on our front. But I said, where did this plank came from? Some of them were splitted. They were at the front of the our compound. So I climbed up. When I looked, brethren, behold, a roof from another upstairs that is far away from me. The wind carried it, and it was about to come and land on my apartment. But the Lord, you know, the apostle was saying what happened, you know, the day they traveled, when they were coming from that Abba, he was, you know, saying something that the Lord can use his eyes to guide you like this. In fact, I said, this is the gospel truth. The Lord used his eyes to guide the roof that was flying like a kite and carried it away from my apartment and rest it on the wall side that is between me and another building.
This other woman always finds it very difficult to sleep whenever she travels to her village. Last time she traveled, she discovered that all is well with her. She had sound sleep. as a result of the God protection on her through the church vest she put on, tagged, "The Lord is my shield."
Church, do prayer. So,
I sleep.
Nothing like the sleep, just they go free.
Hallelujah. She still testifies, still on this church.
Yes.
Even when I go, say, for saying back when I'm here, and so are you. This said, do prayer. Of course, before nothing like that for me, but this was something push me. Pray.
The church worldwide, the global recovery vessel, reaching millions of vulnerable souls all over the entire world with the voice of Christianity,
like our,
bringing the message of salvation.
Return, says, thank God for that.
According to our reading today,
Anytime.
Yes, she does.
How many times has that happened?
How many times?
Now he became universal. That as many as receive him,
whoever
need.
George, come. My husband was very, very sick since last week, and before then he had sick cough started disturbing him.
God healed her husband from chronic cough and also blessed the work of her hand. She got favored from her employer. Her employer refused to increase her wages, but the day she put on the church vest, tied to "The Lord is my shield," she received favor in her working place.
So you now remember the sticker. You start using it and rub on your body.
You remember the title of the sticker.
No type of sticker you don't use to buy. All type of sticker you
own.
So you start using all of them, you're rubbing on your chest. Praying, the Lord God deliver him. I will pray for myself that God, please. So I don't, because I was afraid of the cough. God, no, I don't want to be a widow. Please deliver my husband. My husband is to your hand, though. Even my after that, you receive healing.
The Lord is my shield. Eh? You wore it.
Yes.
You wear them for body.
Yes. When I wear it to the working place.
To workplace.
Yes.
And then what happened?
They start talking of increment. Salary.
They were talking of increment.
Yes, they have not said, they refused to increase before when I put it on.
They refuse.
They've been arguing.
Hold on, put that in her mouth. They refuse.
They refuse to increase it ever since.
Then you put this on.
Yes, that day they agreed that they will increase it.
Log into our channel
www.recoverychurch.tv. Isaiah 43:19. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness, rivers in the desert. It's your turn to celebrate.
Is there anything you are passing through? Yes. Do you think it's not possible to transform you? No, it is possible. Apostle and prayer team are there to receive your call. All what you need to do is just to dial any of those numbers you are seeing on your screen, and they will be glad to receive your call. They will pray and intercede on your behalf, and your life will be transformed. God richly bless you.